Well, it was just over 40 years ago that one of the most stunning stars of the big screen, Natalie Wood, and talented, died in a drowning accident. To this day, it remains one of Hollywood's greatest mysteries. What really happened on that boat with Natalie, her husband Robert Wagner, and Christopher Walken? Natalie's sister, Lana Wood, is on a mission to uncover the truth, but also to celebrate the life and the legacy of her older sister. I had the great thrill of catching up with Lana for this very candid conversation.
From the age of 10, Lana Wood was lighting up the screen and stealing scenes from Hollywood legends like John Wayne.
You ain't much bigger than when I last saw you.
Deborah, there's Lucy over there.
In fact, Lana's first movie role was alongside the Duke himself in The Searchers.
John Wayne was lovely to me. I felt very safe when he was around. He was this towering presence who would share his Allen Berry's blackcurrant pastilles, which he always had with him. They're really good, by the way. I still buy them. I am incredibly grateful and very proud of the fact that I was in The Searchers.
That movie turned out to be something of a family affair. You see, Lana played her big sister Natalie Wood's younger character in that now iconic John Ford-directed Western. The young sisters were Hollywood royalty, and growing up in the spotlight gave them an unbreakable bond. They were best friends, which made Natalie's mysterious drowning in 1981 all the more shocking for Lana.
The Los Angeles coroner today is saying actress Natalie Wood was drunk when she apparently slipped into the ocean.
Take me back to 1981 and the moment you first heard that shocking news.
The news came on and they said that her body was found floating in Catalina. I still couldn't believe it. I mean, talk about classic denial. That doesn't happen to my sister. She's strong. She's highly intelligent. She doesn't give in to foolish things. It couldn't have happened to her.
Lana, when did you first have doubts that that original story that is so well known, that Natalie apparently heard a dinghy bashing on the side of the Splendor, went down to investigate, fell into the water. When did you originally have doubts that that story essentially didn't hold water?
I always questioned it. Otherwise, I would not have gone up to RJ's bedroom after the funeral and asked him what happened. Please tell me what happened.
So when you did that, Lana, what did he say?
He said it was an accident. She probably went off in the dinghy to party because she was that kind of woman. I was flabbergasted. I can't even find words to tell you how angry I was. First of all, in a nightgown and wool socks, you know, she's been insulted, she's been portrayed wrong.
In your heart of hearts, you know this was no accident, don't you?
Oh no, absolutely, it was not an accident. Now, was it a momentary madness? Yeah, it was. Things got out of control.
For four decades, Lana has been on a quest for the truth to find out what really happened on November 29, 1981.
Why won't you speak to the detectives? They're super guys. Clear yourself if you can.
Why would you even bring up anything like that?
The death was ruled an accidental drowning, something Lana says simply isn't true, and she lays out her reasons in her latest bombshell book, Little Sister. Just over 10 years ago, the investigation into Natalie Wood's death was reopened as new evidence was presented and Robert Wagner was named a person of interest.
The case is still open. RJ is still considered a person of interest. They're still hoping for more witnesses because, as the district attorney said, there's still no smoking gun. But the detectives feel differently.
Did Robert Wagner ever call you? I mean, in the hours following her passing?
Oh, no. I never heard from him.
For Lana, her big sister's marriage to Hollywood star Robert Wagner was of concern from the get-go. But when Robert and Natalie reunited and remarried 10 years after their 1962 divorce, Lana was left deeply troubled.
She announced before dinner that she and RJ were going to remarry. And I was rather stunned. I said, Natalie, what are you doing? And she said to me, well, sometimes the devil you know is better than the devil you don't. That's not a reason to get married. I openly sobbed at their wedding and through the wedding until it was over, and Natalie came up to me and said, you know, what's wrong? And I said, I'm going to lose you. He's going to take you away from me. Interesting that I said that way back then, because it proved true.
And you also write in your book, you drop a shocker that you caught Robert Wagner in a situation with another man.
Yeah, she did. Natalie walked in on it. That was devastating to her.
My heart just aches to think of what she went through in life. You reveal, obviously, a long-standing rumour, you confirm it, that your sister was raped when she was a teenager. You name the rapist as Kirk Douglas. Did you ever fear that there might be a reprisal?
No, I felt I had to say everything I did say for her, and I want people to know.
I feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay.
While Natalie was making a name for herself in musicals like West Side Story and Gypsy, Lana was sizzling up the small screen as Sandy Weber, the temptress in TV's original primetime soap opera, Peyton Place.
I'm your wife. If I hang around here, I'm going to run into Rodney.
Sure.
I mean it. Now, what am I supposed to do, stay away?
You're supposed to act like you're married to me.
Diamonds are forever.
Then, in 1971, Lana takes on the role of a lifetime as the sexy and seductive Bond girl Plenty O'Toole in Diamonds Are Forever alongside Sean Connery. And their on-screen chemistry soon moved off-screen.
Hi, I'm Plenty.
But of course you are.
You write very candidly about the fact that you two were lovers. When you did those love scenes, did you chuckle together? I mean, you must have been laughing.
I was terrified that somebody would see more to my reactions. So I tried to play it in a certain way.
Hey, listen, you can't do this to me. Stop that. I've got friends in this town.
We tried to keep it seriously on the down low. I really didn't want anybody to ever know.
Was it a really sad moment for you, his passing?
Oh, yes. Devastating. Absolutely. Still is.
Recent years have been a string of setbacks and heartaches for the six times married Lana. Her daughter Evan died in 2017 at the age of 42, and in that same year, Lana found herself homeless. Despite the seeming never-ending tragedies and heartbreaks that haunt Lana, she keeps smiling and she keeps fighting to ensure her sister Natalie's life and legacy is never forgotten.
She was fun. She was always wonderful to be around. She said to me, they only like me because I'm Natalie Wood, the movie star. I want to find someone who just likes me. Just Natalie.